I have discussed it. Okay, right. We solve the transportation problem in two steps. We solve the transportation problem in two phases or two steps. In the first step, we find initial basic feasible solution by using one of the two methods, that is Vogel's approximation method, and another method is least cost method. So by using one of these two methods, first we find initial basic feasible solution. In the next step, we optimize the initial basic feasible solution using UV method or Modi method. Okay. Right. First two, I discuss Vogel's approximation method to find initial basic feasible solution. So this method gives a basic feasible solution close to optimal solution. Okay. So among these two methods, that is Vogel's approximation method and another method, least cost method. Among these two methods, this Vogel's approximation method gives a solution close to optimal solution. So this method gives a basic feasible solution which is near to optimal solution. So if the method is not mentioned, it is better to use Vogel's approximation method to find initial basic feasible solution. So this will be given in one more questions. Which method gives a basic feasible solution close to an optimal solution? Okay, so that is Vogel's approximation method, VAM. V for Vogel's, A for approximation, M for method, VAM, Vogel's approximation method. Okay, now what are the steps in this method? First step, compute the differences called penalties between the smallest and next to the smallest cost in each row and each column. First, we compute differences or penalties. Both are same. So what is difference or what is penalty? That is difference between smallest and next to the smallest cost in each row and each column. First, we consider first row, identify the least cost and identify the next to least cost and take the difference. That is row one penalty. Similarly, for other rows, we calculate. And similarly, for columns, we calculate these penalties. Okay. So penalty means difference between smallest and next to the smallest cost in each row and each column. So after finding these penalties, right, before that, suppose in a row, there are two costs for smallest. Suppose if two unit costs tie for being the smallest, then take the penalty is zero. Suppose in a row, there are two entries with the least cost. So in that case, you take the penalty as zero for that row. Okay. So after finding all these penalties, identify the row or column with the largest penalty. Among the penalties, we consider the largest penalty. That largest penalty may corresponding to a row or corresponding to a column. Okay. So we identify the largest penalty. Suppose, again, if a tie occurs here, we may use arbitrary tie breaking choice. Suppose there are more than one penalty with the largest. So in that case, arbitrarily, we can take any one. There is no rule to break the tie. Okay. Let the largest penalty corresponding to row I. Suppose the largest penalty occur corresponding to row I. Then in that row I, identify the least cost cell. So identify least cost cell in row I. And let it be ij cell. Okay, ij cell means in row I, jth cell, that is jth column. That cell having least cost in the row I. Okay, so identify the least cost cell in row I. Let it be I comma j cell. So that means here first suffix represent origin, second suffix represent destination. Okay, so from origin I to destination j, that cell has least cost cell. Okay, so for this cell, by Dation variables, how many number of units to be transported? X, I, J. That is the Dation variable. Okay. So for this I comma J cell, The Dation variable is x, I, j. That is the number of units to be transported from origin I to destination j. Okay. So we take that. So put x, I, j equal minimum of a, I, b, j. Put x, I, j equal minimum of a, I, b, j. What is the notation for a, I and b, j? A, I is available amount at origin I. B, j is required amount at destination j. So among these two amounts, we consider minimum value. We assign it to that cell. So that means that minimum value amount is to be transported from origin I to destination j. Okay, right. So here we have three possibilities. So what is the relation between these two values? Either AI less than BJ, or AI is greater than BJ, or AI equal BJ. So we have three possibilities. First possibility, if AI is less than BJ, if AI is less than BJ, then what is XIJ? If AI is less than BJ, then minimum of these two is AI. So then XIJ equal AI. So what does it mean? So XIJ equal AI. That means from origin I to destination J, number of units to be transported is AI. And but this AI is available amount at origin I. So that means the total available amount at origin I is transported to destination J. So in that case, rho constraint is satisfied. That is, rho I constraint is satisfied. So that means we cross out the rho I. That means we delete the rho I. Okay. And write this AI in the cell I comma j and circle it. So that represent a basic cell. Okay. This is first possibility. Second possibility, if AI is greater than BJ, then XIJ equal BJ. Okay. Second possibility, if AI is greater than BJ. So what does it mean? There is some surplus amount available at origin compared with the requirement amount of destination J. So in this case, what is minimum of these two? BJ. So then XIJ equal BJ. That means the number of units to be transported from origin I to destination J is BJ units. So what does it mean? What is this BJ? This is total requirement at destination J. That means, what does it mean? The total required amount at destination J is obtained from origin I. So that is the meaning of this. So that means the destination constraint is satisfied. That is, the requirement of that destination is fulfilled. So that means column constraint is satisfied. So then we cross out column J. That means we delete column J from the table. Okay. And third possibility, both are same. If AI equal BJ, then XIJ equal AI equal BJ. Okay. In this case, we have to observe one point. AI equal BJ means the available amount at origin I is equal to the required amount at destination J. So in this case, number of units to be transported is AI or BJ. Both are same. So XIJ equal AI equal BJ. That means here in this case, the total available amount at origin I is transported to destination J. At the same time, the total required amount at destination J is obtained from origin I. That means both the rho constraint as well as column constraints are satisfied. Okay. So in this case, we have to assign a small quantity epsilon, which tends to zero, to the neighboring cell with least cost, and then cross out rho I and column j. Okay. So in this case, we have to keep in mind this point. Whenever for a cell, the corresponding available amount is equal to corresponding required amount, then assign that amount to that variable. And also you have to assign a small quantity epsilon, which tends to zero, to the neighboring cell with the least cost, and then cross out rho I and column j. So in this case, the solution is said to be degenerate solution. In this case, the solution is said to be degenerate solution. Okay. So already I have discussed what is a degenerate solution. If there are less than m plus n minus 1 strictly positive allocations, then that solution is called as degenerate solution. So here the small quantity epsilon means it is zero, it tends to zero. Okay, so this is the point you have to keep in mind. So here one more question will be given. Okay, so the transportation problem, how the degeneracy exists? In the transportation problem, how the degeneracy exists? Okay, so you have to write for that. In finding initial basic feasible solution for a cell, the corresponding available amount equal corresponding required amount, then the solution is degenerate solution. Okay, so that is the point. So I will discuss one more questions after completing the second unit. Okay, right. And another question, how do you resolve the degeneracy in the transportation problem? How do you resolve the degeneracy in the transportation problem? By assigning a small quantity epsilon which tends to zero to the neighboring cell with least cost. By that we can resolve the degeneracy in the transportation problem. So these two will be given in one more questions. Okay, right. So at the end of this fifth step, we get that either one row constraint or one column constraint or both a row and column constraints are satisfied. So we remove those column or row or column and row from the table. So we get the remaining table. For the remaining table, again, we repeat the same process. Again, compute row and column penalties for the reduced transportation table and go to step one. So repeat the same process. So we find the penalties for the remaining transportation table and we find the largest penalty and we proceed as in step five. Okay. So we have to continue this until all row and column constraints are satisfied. So repeat the procedure until the entire row and column constraints are satisfied. Okay. So this is the first step in solving transportation problem. First we find initial basic feasible solution. Okay, I will discuss second step after doing the small problem. Write this problem. Solve the following transportation problem. Use Voegele's approximation method to find initial basic feasible solution. So use Voegele's approximation method to find initial basic feasible solution. So this is the tabular form of the problem. Write this problem. See the table. So these are S1. Actually, these are S1. This is S2. This is S3. Okay. So there are three origins or sources, S1, S2, S3, and four destinations, D1, D2, D3, D4. Okay, and these are the supply, these are the available amounts at origins. 7 is available at first origin, 9 is available at second origin, 18 is available at third origin, and these are requirement amounts at destinations. At the first destination, required amount 5 units, at second destination 8 units, third destination 7, fourth destination 14. So these are the available amounts at origins, these are the required amounts at destinations, and these are transportation cost per one unit from various origins to various destinations. Suppose this 19 is transportation cost per one unit from first origin to first destination. Suppose this is, if you consider this, is 40. This is transportation cost per one unit from second origin to third destination. Okay. So these entries represent transportation cost per one unit from various origins to various destinations. Okay. So that is the meaning of this table. So remember, rows represent origins and column represent destinations. So whatever the notation here you have, whatever the notation here you have, rows represent origins and column represent destination. Okay. So we have to solve this problem. But here the method is mentioned, use Vogel's approximation method to find initial basic feasible solution. So you have to use Vogel's approximation method to find initial basic feasible solution. Okay. Right. Solution. So before going to solve the problem, first we have to verify the condition. So what is the assumption in the transportation problem? The sum of available amounts equal sum of required amounts. We have to check it before going to solve the problem. Okay. First, take sigma AI, the sum of these values, 7 plus 9 plus 18, that is 34. This is sum of available amounts at origins. Next, sum of required amounts, sigma BJ, sum of these four values, 5 plus 8 plus 7 plus 14. This is also 34. So both are same. So sigma AI called sigma BJ. So the problem is balanced transportation problem. So before going to solve the transportation problem, we have to check whether it is balanced or unbalanced. So for that, find sum of available amounts, that is sigma AI, and find sum of required amounts, that is sigma BJ. So here both are same. So the given problem is balanced transportation problem. Okay, right. First, we find initial basic feasible solution. Since method is mentioned by Vogel's approximation method, right? So initial basic feasible solution by Vogel's approximation method. Initial basic feasible solution by Vogel's approximation method. Okay, right. So you have to take this table. So draw this table roughly. So it is better to use the pencil to draw the table and write the entries with the pencil. So these are row suffixes, row 1, row 2, row 3. These are column suffixes, first column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4. Last column is available amounts AI. Last row is required amounts BJ. And write the cost at northwest corner of each cell. Write the cost at northeast corner of each cell. So write the cost in हेलो Is PPT visible? Now is PPT visible? Okay, right. Right. First we find initial basic feasible solution by Vogel's approximation method. So take this table, tabular form. So already I have discussed this. So write the cos. Write the cost in northeast corner of each cell. Okay. Right. So what is the Vogel's approximation method? What are the steps in that method? What are the steps involved in the Vogel's approximation method? We have to find penalties for rows and columns. So right here penalties. Here we write row penalties. Here we write column penalties. So right here penalties. Okay. These are column penalties. These are row penalties. Right. What is first row penalty? First row means we have to consider up to here only. These are the entries. The column means these are the entries. You need not consider these one. These are the available amounts. These are available amounts. These are required amounts. You have to consider only these entries. Okay. Right. What is first row penalty? Penalty means difference between least cost and next to the least cost. So in the first row, least cost is 10. Least cost is 10. Next to least cost is 19. So difference of these two, 19 minus 10, that is 9. Right here, this is first row penalty. So this is first row penalty. Okay. Similarly, find second row penalty. In second row, least cost is 30, and next least cost is 40. So difference is 10. Right here, 10. This is second row penalty. Similarly, third row, least cost 8, next to least cost 20. So difference. Difference is 12. So this is not 19, this is 12. Okay. So these three are row penalties. Next, column penalty. First column penalty. In first column, least cost is 19, next least is 40, so difference is 21, right here. This is first column penalty. Similarly, second column penalty, least cost 8, next least 30, so difference 22. So this is second column 2 penalty. Third column penalty, least cost 40, next least cost 50, so difference 10. Fourth column. Least cost 10, next least cost 20, so difference 10. So these are the column penalties. Okay, so these are row penalties and these are column penalties. So among these penalties, identify the largest penalty. Right, first step, largest penalty equal, what is the largest penalty? 22. So this is largest penalty. So this appear for column 2. The largest penalty equal 22 for column 2. So then identify the least cost cell in column 2. So least cost cell in column 2. So in column 2, least cost is 8. This is least cost. So that is 3-2 cell. So that is 3-2 cell. So least cost cell in column 2 equal 3-2 cell. So for this cell, allotment, that is the number of units to be transported from third origin to second destination, that is the destination variable x32 equal minimum of, for this cell, corresponding available amount 18 and corresponding required amount 8. So minimum of this, minimum of 18, 8. So for this cell corresponding available amount 18 and corresponding required amount 8. So minimum of 18, 8, that is 8. Okay, so right here 8. So in 3-2 cell, write this allotment 8 and circle this 8. So that represent it is a basic cell or it is a basic variable. Okay, right, observe which constraint is satisfied here. So for this cell, corresponding requirement amount 8 and corresponding available amount 18. So minimum of these two, 8. So what does it mean? At third origin, 18 units are available. Out of 18 units, 8 units are transported to second destination. At third origin, 18 units are available. Out of 18, 8 units are transported to second destination. Okay, so that is the meaning of this. See, in other words, at the second destination, 8 units are required. All those 8 units are obtained from third origin. So that is the meaning of this. So column constraint is satisfied here. Column constraint is satisfied. So cross off column 2. We cross off column 2. So circle the column 2. So we cross off column 2. That means column 2 constraint is satisfied. So we remove the column 2 from the table. Okay, right. So observe the another thing here. At third origin, total units available 18. Out of 18, 8 are transported. Okay. So remaining available amounts at third origin is 18 minus 8, that is 10. You have to balance that. You have to simplify that available, remaining available amount or remaining required amount. Okay. So at third origin, out of 18 units, 8 units are transported. So the remaining available amount is 18 minus 8, that is 10. So right here, cancel 18 and write 10. Still at third origin, 10 units are available. Okay, so this is the first step. Similarly, we repeat the same process for the remaining reduced transportation table. So what is remaining reduced transportation table? Remove second column. So you have only first three and four columns only. For this remaining table, we repeat the same process. So find the penalties for the reduced transportation table. So here, since column is eliminated, here column is removed from the table, row penalties may change. Okay. For the three columns, the column penalties remain same. So for first column, the penalty remains same. For third column, penalty remains same. For fourth column, penalty remains same. Since no cell is deleted in columns. But in rows, since column is eliminated, in rows one cell is deleted. So row penalties may change. Okay, right. Calculate first row penalty. So in the remaining table, first row penalty. The least cost 10. Next to least cost 19. So difference of these two. Again, same 9. Right here. Take comma. Second row penalty. Second row least cost 40. Next to least cost 60. So difference is 20. Okay. So second row penalty 20. Third row penalty. Least cost 20. Next to least 40. So difference is 20. So these are row penalties for the reduced transportation table. Column penalties may remain same since there is no deletion in the cells. All cells remain. So the penalties for columns same. So repeat the same process. So identify the largest penalty. What is the largest penalty here? What are the penalties first? 21, 10, 10, and 9, 20, 20. Among these, largest penalty is 21. This is for column 1. The largest penalty equal 21 for column 1. Largest penalty equal 21 for column 1. Okay. Right. So in column 1, least cost cell. So least cost cell is, least cost is 19 in column 1. Okay, least cost is 19. That is 11 cell. That is 11 cell. So least cost cell in column 1 equal 11 cell. So for this cell, the deletion variable is x11. So what is x11? For this cell, corresponding available amount 7 and correspond required amount 5. So minimum of these two, 7 and 5. So x11 equal minimum of 7 comma 5. The minimum is 5. Okay. Write 5 in first cell. Write 5 here in first cell and circle it. And circle it. That means this is basic cell or basic variable. Okay. Right. Now which constraint is satisfied? Observe these two. This is 5. This is 5. That means the total required amount as first destination is 5. So it is completely obtained from first origin. That means column constraint is satisfied. So cross off column 1. Cross off column 1. So cross out column 1. Okay, right. Observe at first origin. Observe at first origin. At first origin, available amount 7. Out of 7, 5 units are transported to first destination. So remaining available amount 7 minus 5, 2. So cancel the 7 and write remaining amount 2. So still at first origin, 2 units are available. Okay, so at the end of second step, first two columns are satisfied. First two column constraints are satisfied. So we have eliminated these two columns. Okay, so repeat the same process for remaining table. So what is the remaining table? So this is the remaining table. This is the remaining table. For this remaining table, repeat the same process. Okay, right. Here, column is eliminated, row penalties may change. But column penalties for these two columns remain same. Okay, right. What is first row penalty? We have only two cells in first row. So one is least and another is next least. So 10, 50, difference 40. Okay, so difference 40. 40, second row, 40, 60, difference 20. 70, 20, difference 50. And these column penalties remain same. Okay. Now the penalties for resulting table are these. 40, 20, 50, 10, 10. Okay, since all cells in the columns remain same, there is no change in the cells. So column penalties remain same. These two remain same. Again, repeat the same process. What is the largest penalty among these? 50. So 50 is the largest penalty. So largest penalty equaled 50 for row 3. Largest penalty equaled 50 for row 3. Next. Least cost cell in row 3. Least cost cell in row 3. Row 3 means we have to remove these two cells. First, we have to remove these two cells. These are eliminated. You have to consider only these two. Among these two, least cost is 20. That is 3, 4 cell. So least cost cell in row 3 equal 3, 4 cell. For this cell, the decision variable is x34. So what is x34? For this cell, corresponding available amount 10 and corresponding required amount 40. So minimum of these two. So x34 equal minimum of 10, 14. So minimum is 10. Minimum is 10. So write here 10 and circle it. So observe which constraint is satisfied. At third origin, available amount is 10. So all available amount at third origin is transported to fourth destination. That is, row constraint is satisfied. So cross off row 3. Cross off row 3. So circle row 3. Okay, so row 3 constraint is satisfied, so cross off row 3. Observe fourth destination. At fourth destination, total required amount is 14. Out of 14, 10 units are obtained from third origin. Still, the requirement at fourth destination is 14 minus 10, 4. Here, cross off 14. 14 minus 10, 4, right? Here, 4. That is, still required amount is 4. So still required amount is 4. So you have to keep in mind this point. At each step, we have to simplify the remaining available amount or remaining required amount. Okay. Right. So we have deleted two columns. First column, second column, and one row, third row. And the remaining transportation table is these four cells. That is row 1, row 2, column 3, column 4. So this is the resulting transportation table, or remaining transportation table. You have to repeat the same process for this table. So observe here, in the previous table, this is the previous table. This is the previous table. From previous table, row is eliminated. Row is eliminated. That means column penalties change. Column penalties change. So for first two rows, these penalties remain same. These remain same. Okay. So column penalties will change. Now what is first? What is third column penalty? We have only two cells, 40 and 50. So difference of these two, 10. Fourth column penalty, 10, 60, so difference is 50. Okay. So at this step, the penalties are 10, 50, 40, 20. So these are the penalties. These are the penalties. Among these, largest penalty is 50. So largest penalty equaled 50 for column 4. The largest penalty called 50 for column 4. Next, same process. Least cost cell in column 4. Least cost cell in column 4. So in column 4, we have only two cells. Least cost is 10. This is 1-4 cell. This is 1-4 cell. So for this national variable is x14. x14 equal minimum of corresponding available amount and required amount. So for this cell, corresponding available amount is 2 and corresponding required amount is 4. So minimum of these two. So minimum of 2 comma 4 is 2. So minimum is 2. Right here 2 and circle it. Observe at first origin, 2 units are available. All 2 units are transported to fourth destination. That means row 1 constraint is satisfied. So cross off row 1. Cross off row 1. So circle row 1. That means delete row 1. Okay, right. Observe fourth destination. At fourth destination, required amount is 4. Fourth destination, required amount is 4. Out of 4, 2 units are obtained from first origin. So out of 4, 2 are obtained. Still remaining requirement is 4 minus 2, 2. Cancel this 4 and write here 2. So still requirement at fourth destination is 2 units. So finally, we have only 2 cells in the table. Finally, we have only 2 cells in the table. Among these 2, least cost cell is 2-3 cell. So least cost is 40. So least cost is 40. Okay. That is 2-3 cell. 2-3 cell. So for this cell, corresponding available amount 9 and corresponding required amount 7. So minimum of these 2. So this is 2-3 cell. So x23 equal minimum of 9 comma 7. So minimum is 7. Write in 2-3 cell 7 and circle it. Okay, observe at third destination, required amount is 7 units. All 7 units are obtained from second origin. That means column constraint is satisfied. So cross off column 3. So cross off column 3. Observe at second origin. Observe the second origin. At second origin, available amounts 9. Out of 9 units, 7 units are transported to third destination. So remaining available amount 9 minus 7, 2. So still 2 units are available at second origin. This is. So finally, we have only one cell. Finally, we have only one cell, that is 2-4 cell. Finally, we have only one cell, that is 2-4 cell. So for this cell, what is corresponding available? 2. And corresponding required is also 2. Okay. So x24 equal minimum of these 2. So same 2. So here observe. So finally, you get only one cell for which the corresponding available amount equal the corresponding required amount. Then only the calculation is correct. Otherwise, the calculation is wrong or the problem may be unbalanced problem. Okay. So in this process, suppose if you get finally only one cell for which the corresponding available amount is not equal to corresponding required amount, in such case, your calculation is wrong or the problem may be unbalanced transportation problem. Okay. So before going to solve the problem, initially you have to check whether the problem is balanced or unbalanced. If the problem is balanced, then only we have to proceed. Otherwise, you have to modify it. So we will discuss later. Okay. So once the problem is balanced, if you calculate sequentially without any mistake, finally you will get only one cell. Finally, you will get only one cell for which the corresponding available amount is equal to corresponding required amount. If you get that, then only your calculation is right. Otherwise, the calculation is wrong. We have to check another. We have to restart the problem. Okay. So it is difficult to check where the calculation is wrong, where the mistake has been done. So it is very difficult to check. Okay. So completely erase the table. You start with a fresh table. Okay. So once you done mistake, it is difficulty to identify that mistake. Okay. So you have to do carefully the calculations. Okay. Right. So finally, all constraints are satisfied. So we get an initial basic feasible solution. Okay. Right. So the initial basic feasible solution is right in tabular form. So remove the last column and the last row, the available amounts and required amounts. You can remove this last column and last row. Okay. Just take the rows and columns and write the corresponding basic variables only. Okay. So from previous table, what are the basic variables? 1-1 cell, one basic variable, and 1-4 cell, one basic variable. Next to 2-3 cell and 2-4 cell and 3-2 cell and 3-4 cell. Okay. So you write all these cells. So this is the initial basic feasible solution. Okay. Observe here how many number of basic cells we have to get, that is m plus n minus 1. We have to get m plus n minus 1 basic cells. So here m is 3, n is 4, that is 7 minus 1, that is 6. We have to get 6 basic cells. So count the basic cells. So this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So this is a non-degenerate basic feasible solution. So all the allocations, these are called allocations. So all the allocations are strictly greater than 0. So this is a non-degenerate basic feasible solution to the transportation problem. Okay. So what is the meaning of this solution? See here. Suppose consider first row, that is first origin. From first origin, 5 units are transported to first destination and 2 units are transported to fourth destination. So this is the meaning of this solution. From first origin, 5 units are transported to first destination, 2 units are transported to fourth destination. Similarly, from second origin, 7 units are transported to third destination and 2 units are transported to fourth destination. And from third origin, 8 units are transported to second destination and 10 units are transported to fourth destination. So this is the meaning of this solution. So this is in terms of origins. Similarly, in terms of destinations, observe first column. First destination. Okay. First destination require amount 5 units. Okay. So the whole requirement of first destination is obtained from first column. That is 5 units. The whole requirement of second destination is obtained from third origin. The whole requirement of third destination is obtained from second origin. The requirement of fourth destination is obtained 2 units from first origin, 2 units from second origin, and 10 units from third origin. Okay, so that is the meaning of the solution in terms of destinations. Okay, so observe the initial table, check the column constraints and row constraints. Okay, so what is the first row? Total available amount at first row is 5 plus 2, that is 7. And total available amount at second origin, 7 plus 2, 9. Total available at third origin is 10 plus 8, 18. So see the in the original problem, these values. We have to check these values. These values should be tallied. Similarly, requirement at first destination is 5. This is 5. Second destination requirement, 8. Third destination requirement, 7. Fourth destination requirement, 10 plus 2 plus 2, that is 14. Okay, so 13 plus 7, 20, 34. This is the total requirement, 34. Total available, 16 plus 18, 34. Okay, so problem is, that is, all constraints are satisfied. So the solution is correct. So this is the checking of the solution. Okay, right. So this is initial basic feasible solution, not an optimal solution. Just it is an initial basic feasible solution. So in the next solution, we have to improve the next step. We have to optimize this solution using another method, that is UV method or Modi method. Okay, I will discuss in the next class. Here, what is the transportation cost? Okay, so per one unit cost is 19. Per one unit, transportation cost is 19 units. So here, 5 units are transported. So cost is 19 into 5. Okay, here, per one unit, transportation cost 10. So we have transported 2 units, so cost 10 into 2, here 40 into 7, here 60 into 2, here 8 into 8, here 20 into 10. So take sum of all these products. So 19 into 5 plus 10 into 2 plus 40 into 7 plus 60 into 2 plus 8 into 8 plus 20 into 10. So that is the transportation cost to transport all the goods available at origins to destinations. Okay, so this transportation cost corresponding to this solution. So it is not an optimal solution, just it is initial basic feasible solution. Okay, in the next step we have to optimize this solution using UV method or Modi method. Next, what about the other cells? What about this cell and this cell, this cell? All these are non-basic cells. All these are non-basic cells. So their values are zeros. This is zero, this is zero, this is zero. Okay, so that means there is no transportation from second origin to first destination. Similarly, there is no transportation from third origin to first destination. Similarly, there is no transportation from first origin to second destination. So that is the meaning of the other cells. Okay, so here these six cells, circle, are basic cells and other cells are non-basic cells. Other cells are non-basic cells. So this is initial basic feasible solution. So in the next class, we optimize this initial basic feasible solution using Modi method or UV method. Okay.